Hold it.
I think you're going to like this picture.
Love That Bob. Starring Bob Cummings.
Hello, all you grown-up kiddies. This is your tell-me-a-story lady, Aunt Schultze. Tonight, I'm going to tell you about the big bad boss and little blonde Riding Hood. Once upon a time, there arrived from Sweden a famous beauty queen named Ingrid. And it became the boss's happy assignment to fly her to a convention. Now, he couldn't speak Swedish, but any teacher would have given him A for effort.
You're going to look sensational in a bathing suit, I know that. By the way, you mocking see swim? Swim? You know, swim?
Yeah.
But alas, the big bad boss never got to first base. He tried everything. He took her riding in his new convertible. He took her swimming in the neighbor's pool. Once, he thought sure he was going to corner her in the dark room.
Ingrid?
Yeah. But he didn't know I was coming in as a pinch hitter. Another time, he thought he had her cornered in the dressing room. Again, he was clobbered by a pinch hitter. Finally came Christmas and mistletoe. This time, he looked like a cinch. He was almost at home plate.
You realize I've never kissed you?
Yeah.
Realize how long I've waited?
Yeah.
Ever since you first came to this country?
Yeah.
You could speak about one word of English then?
Yeah.
Unfortunately, that wasn't the word.
No?
That was the word, yeah.
Nobody misses under the mistletoe. But he did, thanks to Aunt Schultze. However, I must say he finally did manage to get one hit. Pow, right in the kisser. Poor big bad boss. Meantime, back at the house, we pick up the second part of our story, which concerns the boss's nephew, Chuck, Chuck's favorite girl, Carol, and Carol's favorite rock and roll singer, Stanley Stenner.
And the school's beginning, and all the dolls are clinging to the history books. No one ever looks at the guys who give the eyes to all the gals are singing. Seems like a sin, it has to begin just when we're swinging.
Steal my girl, will you? You rock and roll groaner. See how the girls like you with a head full of feathers. Campus hero. All right, all right.
Chuck McDonald.
Oh, hi, Carol.
Did you steal that big picture of Stanley Stenner from in front of the campus theater?
Me?
Well, what are you doing?
Yeah, basketball practice.
Well, I want to talk to you.
Okay, let's step outside.
Carol!
You did take it. Chuck McDonald, you better put this right back where you got it from. Oh, you ruined it.
What do you mean, ruined it? He looks better this way.
This picture cost a lot of money. It was taken by the best photographer in Hollywood.
My Uncle Bob didn't take this.
I didn't say the biggest wolf. I said the best photographer, Wally Sewell.
Wally Sewell? My Uncle Bob can take better pictures than him with one hand tied behind him.
He has to have one hand tied behind him. It's the only way the girls will pose for him. You won't laugh when I show Stanley what you've done to his picture.
Show it to him. I don't care. Go ahead, take it. You can have old Stanley and his
Chuck!
And his guitar and his rock and roll.
And
hold it, Robin Hood. Just what do you think you're doing?
That big ape's trying to steal my girl.
We're Chuck, not going what? Steady, Chuck McDonald. Stanley Stenner has a perfect right
now
to
listen, Carol, you're my girl.
Right and
no overgrown
girl. You did love the girl, so why
don't you hold it! Say, Chuck is a photographer. I cannot stand by and watch you deface a work of art. And that is a work of art. That's a beautiful example of photographic skill. That's a... That's a Sewell portrait.
Yeah. Oh, go, Bob. Go, man. Go, right
now. Now, I know you're wondering how these two parts of my story are going to come together. Well, be patient. You'll see. And now the plot thickens as rock and roll rears its ugly head.
Uncle Bob.
Oh, hi, Jack Boy.
Bob, could you let me have 20 bucks?
What for?
The down payment on a guitar.
A guitar?
Yeah, I'll show that Stanley Stenner that I can sing rock and roll as well as hear anybody
Chuck,
else.
Chuck, if there's one thing this nation does not need, it's another rock and roll singer.
But that's what a girl goes for today.
A girl goes for today exactly what you went for 2,000 years ago.
What's that?
A man. You don't need an overgrown ukulele hanging around your neck to get her, either.
Yeah, but Uncle Bob, I'm
Look,
convinced.
Did Mark Antony start singing when he thought he was going to lose Cleopatra?
No, he stabbed himself.
Well, there you are. Anything's better than becoming a singer.
Let's get down to modern times. What was Ricky Nelson before he started singing?
A 14-year-old millionaire. Any other questions?
Look at Elvis Presley. Please, Uncle Bob, just
Chuck,
20 bucks.
Look, you're my nephew. You don't need a guitar to get a girl.
But, Uncle Bob, you don't know what makes the girls go ape.
Are you kidding? I've been monkeying around since I was 12.
Tell me how to get Carol Rick and Stanley Stenner.
I can tell you a dozen ways, Chuck.
Well, tell me the quickest. You just drove up out front to get Carol.
Well, the quickest is to pick a fight. You see, he's a singer, and he won't want to take a chance on getting hit in the mouth.
Yeah, yeah, so, I get you, Uncle Bob. Hey! Hey, I dare you to get out of that car, Stanley Stenner, you chicken liver crooner!
Is that him, Chuck? Is it the big, tall, husky blonde kid?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, forget it. You've got 11 other ways. You know, I remember a situation exactly like this back in Drury College.
What'd you do? Well, there he is. Hurry. What'd you do?
Well, I threatened the girl.
Oh, hi, Stanley. Come on in.
Hi, Carol. You find that picture?
Yes, it's here. Chuck took it. Come on, just wait till you see it. I was just starting to work on it when you rang the doorbell.
Well, it's only a picture. Mr. Sewell can make another one.
Gee, Stanley, you're big.
Say, you want to come down to Mr. Sewell's office with me?
Oh, I'd love to.
Hold it, baby.
Carol, if you walk out that door with him, you walk out of my life forever.
Goodbye.
This is your last chance. Who's it going to be, him or me?
Him. Goodbye.
This is it, baby. You can't come crying back tomorrow because I won't be here.
Neither will I. Come on, Stanley.
You can't keep me on the string. Make up your mind.
I've made it. Let go of me.
Now, listen, Carol, I want a definite decision. And no
fool. The lady said let go.
Oh, the big crooner wants to get tough, huh?
If I have to.
How would you like a knuckle burger?
Are you going to give it to me, pantyways?
Ooh, that did it. That did it. I dare you to step outside and call me that.
All right.
Well, that got rid of him.
Overgrown vandal. Look at that. Aren't you ashamed of yourself?
Well, no, I didn't take it.
You know who took it.
Oh, that's a Sewell portrait, isn't it? My goodness, Wally. My, you are slipping. That is not a good picture.
Look funny, man.
The subject seems to have holes in his head. Then why else would he come to you?
I didn't have time to hang around here trading insults. Now, there's the negative. Now, make that enlargement. Because if I come back here and find that you haven't made that enlargement...
Hey.
Hey.
Hello, Schultz.
Hi.
Oh, Mr. Sewell. When did you get back from India?
Schultz, take Miss...
Hold it. India?
Oh, hurry into...
Oh, wait. Who told you I was in India?
Your best friend.
Why, you...
Wally, you mean you didn't go after that big talk we had?
What talk? I haven't spoken to you since our last golf game.
Oh, well, that's when you told me something about India. Oh, yes.
All I said was that if I beat you, I'd get to play in the Calcutta.
Oh, play in the Calcutta. I thought you said you were on your way to Calcutta. That's why I let you in.
Miss Goode, my card.
What are you doing, challenging her to a duel? He's afraid of me, so he's going to fight with her.
Please call me when you feel like being photographed by a photographer who can do justice to your...
Thank you. I've heard you do wonderful work.
As for you, funny man, get to work on my picture. I'm coming back to pick it up.
Oh, Wally, I feel so sorry for him. Whenever he goofs, he comes running to me to save him. He just never has gotten the knack of photographing women.
That's a woman?
Oh, yeah. You'd never believe that was Dinah Shore, would you?
Looks like Woody Woodpecker.
What a terrible picture. I don't think I ever want to pose for Mr. Sewell.
Look, Ingrid, let me set you straight on something. Wally Sewell is probably the greatest photographer...
Oh, please continue, Shilty.
...of woodpeckers in the world. But when it comes to people... Well, you just wouldn't believe this was done ashore, now would you?
Ready to go to work?
Yeah. And about tonight, what's the good word?
No.
Well, I've heard better words.
Hey, honey, now listen. Now, look. I'm sure you don't understand my motive for wanting to see you tonight.
I think I do.
No, but please let me explain. You see, Margaret and I had a knockdown, drag-out fight this morning.
Really?
Yes, she argued that American girls are much better trained as cooks and housekeepers than the girls from the old country. But I came to your defense immediately. I said that girls, especially Scandinavian girls, are wonderful cooks and wonderful housekeepers.
Well, thank you.
Oh, don't mention it. Of course, I did kind of go out on a limb defending you like that. I don't believe I've ever seen the inside of your apartment.
I don't believe you have.
No. Now, if you'd invite me over for dinner tonight, I could defend you much better in the future.
Yes, but who would defend me tonight?
Now, watch closely, kiddies. Here's where the two parts of my story come together.
Yes, Chuck. Uncle Bob, I just found a way to get the guitar without it costing you a penny.
Why don't you just...
All I have to do is trade in these old medals of yours.
Well, I'll be darned. Go.
Mom was cleaning out the attic and found them.
Chuck, you know, I'd forgotten all about these.
The guy at the music store says he'll give me a second-hand guitar for them.
When I... Are you kidding? Do you realize these are the top medals of the 12 countries I was in during the war?
Yes, sir.
You realize what I went through to get these, Chuck?
Well, I kind of guessed from the label on the back.
Good. When a man risks...
What'd you go through, Uncle Bob?
I went through a month's pay. That's what I went through.
Well, can I get the guitar?
Boy, do these bring back memories. England.
It's just like new.
Rebecca Knightsbridge.
The same kind Stanley Stenner's got.
France. Madeleine Ledoux.
How about it?
Sweden.
Uncle Bob?
Hey, Chuck. Yeah, what is it?
How about it?
Yeah, I think it's gonna work.
Swell.
It just gotta work.
Swell. Thanks a million,
yeah.
Uncle Bob.
Chuck! Chuck! You think you're going?
To trade in these medals for a guitar so I can get Carol back.
I told you don't need a guitar to get a girl.
Then give me one of those medals. I need something.
Ow!
Uncle Bob.
Ow! Ow! Heaven's sake.
Kiddies, I'm afraid the big bad boss has some sneaky plan in mind. Who could he be calling?
Janitor speaking. Oh, hello, Mr. Cullen.
Oh, what does, excuse me, just a second. Svergis Stotsa Hjalte mean?
Sveris? Sveris Stotsa Hjalte. Oh, that means Sweden's greatest hero.
Sweden's greatest hero. Crazy. Come on up and bring your silver polish. Thanks, Ollie.
Oh, kiddies. It looks bad for little Blonde Riding Hood.
Oh, yentohoya, yentohoya. You know, Miss Schulze? In the eyes of any Swedish person, the man that wears this, he is the greatest. Yeah, sure, he can do no wrong.
Poor Ingrid. Oh, it's gonna be slaughter.
Did you know I got the Swedish medal, too?
The same one.
Oh. No, there is a difference. You see, on this one it says Sveris Största Hjälte, but on mine that says Sveris Största Lögnera.
What's that mean?
Sweden's greatest liar.
What?
You see, back in Sweden where we had this club, once every year we would get together and see who could tell the tallest story, and I win.
Like the Liars Club. Hey, they are remarkably similar, aren't they?
They look so much together, you can't tell them alike. Oh, I mean, if you didn't know Swedish, you couldn't tell one from the other.
Yeah. Ole, how'd you like to trade medals?
You mean that?
Sure.
Oh, but Mr. Collins, he won't like that.
Mr. Collins, he won't know that.
Oh, I see. But he don't know won't hurt him?
Well, it'll hurt him, but he won't know from where is coming the hurt.
You know, Miss Schulze, with this medal, I could be manager of the building again.
Really?
Yeah, sure. A big hero like me can't be a janitor.
Good for you, Ollie. Go get yourself promoted.
Oh, Miss Schulze.
Ollie.
I got it right. I'm a hero.
Little medal, glimmer, glimmer. You'll make his chances even slimmer.
Well, there's Wally's picture. Well, how's the medal coming, huh?
All set, boss.
Yeah. Just wait till Ingrid sees this, hmm?
Yeah.
Now, get in there till I need you.
Boss, how's Ingrid going to see the medal? She's posing for the bathing suit ad, not you.
Never mind, Schulze. Just go ahead and tell her to hurry.
Okay. Those letters are ready for your signature.
Okay, fine, honey.
Ingrid! Boss wants you to hurry.
I'm ready.
Where are you ready?
Do you like this suit?
Oh, honey, it fits you like the skin on a sausage.
You can get a suit like this.
Yeah. Where can I get that kind of sausage?
Uncle Bob?
Yes, Jeff.
Uncle Bob, I just found a guitar that's a terrific bargain.
Shot.
It's in the window of Joe's pawn shop. Only $15 down. How about it?
No.
Oh.
You only want the guitar to impress a girl.
Well, why'd you want the medal?
We're talking about guitars.
Well, Uncle Bob, Carol's flipped over this rock and roll singer. I've got to fight fire with fire.
Well, you can't get a girl with the kind of fire you buy in a pawn shop. That's got to come from in here. Nothing. I just hit something vital. Now run along, will you, Chuck? I've got a very busy afternoon ahead of me here.
Please, Uncle Bob, just $15.
Chuck, I work much too hard for my money to throw it away on a guitar.
Throw it away? I might make $1 million as a rock and roll singer.
Are you kidding? I've never even heard you sing.
Well, of course you haven't. I never tried.
If you don't say the most ridiculous...
Chuck, I'm ready for the beach picture.
Yeah, me too.
Uncle Bob, you always said you'd give me the shirt off your back.
Yeah, but see, I'll need that, Chuck. Excuse me. You can have my pants for the rest of the day, though.
You're the cause of this whole thing, Stanley Skinner.
Well, it looks like the big bad boss has lured little blonde Riding Hood to a deserted beach. But don't worry, Aunt Schulze has switched the medals.
This. There. Honey, just lower your chin just a slight bit and turn your head a little more to your right and hold it. Good. All right, now give me just a funny expression. Just any funny expression. That's it. Fine. Okie doke. Well, now you can stretch out and take a sun bath.
Why don't you take off your shirt and get some sun, too?
Yeah, that's a good idea. Would you mind holding this, please?
Certainly.
Say, you know, I was just thinking when we were coming out in the car.
Isn't that Swedish?
No, that's an American camera. They make some very good...
Oh, no, I mean that medal.
What medal, honey?
That one.
Oh, for heaven's sake, am I still wearing this? I went to a Flyers breakfast this morning, and they insisted I wear it. My goodness, I'm terribly embarrassed.
Why?
Well, you'll think that I wore it just to impress you.
Let me see.
No.
Oh, please.
No, please don't ask me to show it to you. Well, if you insist. Here, I'll put the camera away.
Sverige största lögnare. Sweden's greatest liar.
Well, I guess you understand now why I didn't want to show it to you, huh?
Yes, I do.
I guess you're kind of surprised, aren't you? I guess you didn't think I was the kind of fellow who could win a medal like that, huh?
Oh, no, I think you're just the kind who could.
Really? Thank you very much.
I didn't know you were ever in Sweden.
Well, during the war, you know, just long enough to get the medal. Mm-hmm.
I would like to hear the story.
What story? Oh, you mean how I won the medal. Uh-huh.
Well, all right, let's just stretch out here in the sand, and I'll try to make up, remember how it happened.
So I picked up the two wounded Swedish sailors, one under each arm, you understand? And I dived into the flaming fjord and swam through the burning oil to shore. Of course, luck was with me. If the casts on my broken legs hadn't been asbestos, I never would have made it.
What a story. No wonder they gave you that medal. You're the greatest.
Yeah. Oh, no. There were other great ones in the Air Force. They just didn't happen to get to Sweden, that's all. Oh, hey, look what time it is. Say, we better be getting back to the office.
Ingrid, honey, I don't want to take advantage of any emotion you may feel at the moment. But now that you know what I'm really like, am I invited to dinner tonight?
No.
Now, look, nothing elaborate, just a simple dinner, understand? Just maybe a little candle. Did you say no?
Yes, I said no.
I've gotten better results than this with a good conduct medal.
How was that, Miss Schulze?
Just great, old.
Where is he?
Now, just
where is that saboteur?
Well, if you mean the boss is at the beach with Miss Sweden.
This time he's gone too far.
He even punctured the negative. What are we going to do, Mr. Sewell?
I'll tell you what we're going to do. Come on in here, Stanley. Bring your guitar. We're going to use up every penny's worth of film in this studio. We're going to photograph Stanley in every color and position known to nature. And we're going to enlarge every picture to the size of that window. In short, we're going to bankrupt your boss.
Oh, now, just a second.
Sit over there. Pardon me, will you?
Oh, but wait a minute. I don't have my picture taken with the medal.
Oh! Jag
ser att du har all holiday svensk medalj. Ja,
du svensk.
Ja, min mamma och pappa kommer från det gamla landet.
Ja, jag ser.
Hello, Ingrid.
What is this?
Smorgasbord.
Where's the boss?
Oh, he's stuck to talk to Chuck. How about some music, huh?
Okay. Oh, you're sticking into your drum, the song. Better do rock and roll.
Do you know how to roll a rock and rock the roll?
Oh, yeah.
I said, take that thing back to the pawn shop.
But Joe let me have it on a free trial.
Well, the trial is over and the verdict is guilty. Now take it back. And you can give this to Joe, too, with my compliments. Schulte.
Look, Uncle Bob. Oh. He even gave me a free book of lessons. Guitar wizardry, self-taught. Become a virtuoso overnight.
Why don't you...
And he threw in a pick.
Well, throw it out!
Uncle Bob, when you...
You gotta have arms like a gorilla to play this.
Brain like one, too. Now take that junk back. You'll never get a girl with rock and roll.
That's how Stanley got Carol.
Chuck.
I'm telling you, Uncle Bob, the girls flip.
Even the Swedish girls dig it.
It's not a... Dig what?
Rock and roll, especially Ingrid.
Oh, are you kidding? I couldn't even defrost her with a top Swedish medal of honor.
Boss.
Everybody, but she goes for me. When she's not near me, all I know is she's crying. She's crying.
You see, Uncle Bob? Now can I keep the guitar?
No, you can't.
I love you, darling, when the sun goes down. I love you, darling, when the moon is baking now. I love you, darling.
Kiddies, that's all the time we have tonight. Will the big bad boss get Little Blonde Riding Hood? Will nephew Chuck get his girl back from Stanley Stenner? Tune in next week when Aunt Schulze will reveal all. Good night.
Herself. The part of Carol Henning was played by Olive Sturgis, Wally Sewell by Dan Tobin, Ole Swenson by L. Brendel, and Stanley Stenner played himself. This is Bill Baldwin speaking.